Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. I'm Bearded Fortech. If you're new here, welcome. Please consider hitting that subscribe button. If you're not new here, welcome back. I love everybody, new here or not. I love you all. I just got done doing some transmission work, and I want to show you guys the process that you have to go through when you do internal transmission repairs, what you have to do on drive cycles. So let's get into it. Okay, you can see I'm in this 2021 Super Duty. It's got a 6.7 liter in it. It's the 10 speed automatic transmission. It's the 10R140. And I don't know if you know what 10R140 stands for. 10 stands for 10 speed, R stands for rear wheel drive, and 140 stands for 1400 newton meters input of torque, which comes out to about 1039 foot pounds of torque. And what I did to this thing is I put it had a code. It defaulted to seventh gear, and it had a code for the output shaft speed sensor, which is located, you have to pull the main control, which is the valve body, down, and it sits up and up there. It's got a 8 millimeter nut that holds it in, bolt that holds it in. So while I'm in there, the valve body was looking kind of crusty, so I ended up doing the output shaft speed sensor, the main control valve, which is the valve body, new filter, new fluid, all that stuff. And this right here is the top one is the solenoid body strategy, and the bottom one is the solenoid body ID. And I have to go, after I did all the repairs and got fluid in it, and remind you, this one doesn't have a dipstick. It doesn't even have the dipstick on the passenger side underneath next to the exhaust. This one actually has a 10 millimeter hex inverted that's on the driver's side toward the tail end of the transmission. You'll know it's full when it's running and you pull that plug out and you have transmission fluid, you know, running out of it. But got all the fluid, and I had to download, put those numbers in to program it to the vehicle so it knows which valve body's in it now. Now I gotta drive it until that 169 right there gets to 196, or between 196 and 216 degrees. Then I can continue with the learn strategy. And once I get to that temperature, I'll show you how the learn strategy goes. All right, we are at 197 degrees, 196, 197, and kind of recap on this. I replaced the output shaft speed sensor. I did go through the pinpoint test, checking voltages where they're supposed to be, no voltages where they're not supposed to be, ohming things out. Pinpoint test led to replace that sensor, and so far everything's been good. So now, I am at 197 degrees. It's supposed to be 196 to 216. That is the operating temperature for this vehicle, so I can perform the second step of the drive cycle, or the learn cycle. If you don't perform this, it's going to run like crap the next time. Well, not run, it's going to shift like crap the next time you go to drive it. So here we are at a dead stop. We're going to push the throttle to about 15%, and we are in drive, obviously, about 15%, and we're going to watch it shift from first all the way up to seventh in between 1500 and 1800 RPMs. Okay, once it gets to seventh gear, then I can apply a little bit more throttle until it gets to all 10 gears. So let's try it. Perform that procedure six more times. I forgot the one very important part. Once you're at a stop, you hold the brake for 5 seconds, neutral 1 second, reverse for 2 seconds, back to neutral, back to drive. Then you repeat the process over again. So I'm gonna turn around and do it again so you can see the whole thing. And I am on a dead end road. There's nobody out here. Okay, I'm at a dead stop. Gonna accelerate. We should watch it shift all the way up to 7th. Then I can accelerate a little more. Stop. Hold the brake for 5 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Neutral. 1. Reverse. 1, 2. Neutral. 1. Drive. 1, 2. And we accelerate. And I'm going to do that 5 more times. Alright guys, that is how you do the strategy learn drive cycle after you replace the transmission component, and that has to be done whenever you replace a transmission assembly, whenever you replace the solenoid, a sensor, a clutch pack, or the transmission main control, which is the valve body. That procedure has to be done, and to kind of recap on that, the procedure is you drive it till it gets to operating temperature, which is between 196 and 216 degrees. Once you get to that point, you come to a complete stop while you're still in drive, and you accelerate at about 15% throttle, and you will watch it upshift to about 7th gear. When it gets to 7th gear, then you can apply a little bit more throttle, and then it's going to shift all the way into 10th gear, and the RPM range should be between 15 and 1800 RPMs at each shift point. You're going to repeat that process 6 more times after the initial one, so it's a total of 7 times. And once that's done, that drive cycle is now complete. The transmission control module has learned the shift points, it has learned the strategy, and it is good to operate and give back to the customer. So I hope you guys learned. It takes a little bit more than just throwing a valve body in there and sending it on its way. So it's, you got to go through the drive cycle, otherwise it's going to shift like crap. You'll get shifting concern complaints and stuff like that. So as always, I love you guys. I appreciate you tuning into this one, and I will see you on the next one.